Am I coming all right? Is the lighting okay?
Yes, it's fine.
Okay.
Wonderful. Yes.
So welcome, you beautiful people, to the third episode of Conversation of Possibilities with Chandana, Bawa and Naresh Dayal. Thank you so much, Naresh Uncle, for being on and actually creating this conversation and being with us. And thank you, Chandana, for creating this in the first place.
Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you, darling.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Chandana, for inviting me to have this conversation, and Reshma to have organized all of this. I'm really grateful, and grateful to all the beautiful people who are on right now and all the others who would be joining us a bit late.
Yes. Welcome.
I've seen in both that as the time goes, more and more people join in.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. And it's been so wonderful just seeing how, you know, it's been such a beautiful contribution. And I'm just so grateful to everyone who joins us.
Yeah.
With the questions and with everything else that shows up, the possibilities are just kind of expanding and expanding. And it's beautiful. And welcome, Naresh Dayal, Mr. Naresh Dayal, who happens to be from Mumbai for now and happens to be in Delhi. And I would actually love to ask you to actually speak a little bit about how you came into access and stuff like that.
Well, the first thing, Chandana, I am living in Mumbai, but I am from Delhi.
Yes.
I would say better part of my life I have spent, more part of my life I have spent in Delhi.
Right.
My schooling, my college, as a matter of fact, what brings me to Delhi this time is my Golden Jubilee. And thank you for inviting me for this wonderful conversation that you have been having. I hope I will be able to contribute something to the people who are online and people who see it later.
I'm sure you will. You already are a contribution, a massive one. It's like, so tell me, when did you get introduced to the tools of access, and how did you get introduced, and what had you choosing something that's so crazy and so wacky?
Well, you know, it's been a long journey. There were many issues which I had, and I had acknowledged that they required fixing.
Yeah.
So I had done a lot of modalities, and somebody in 2013 suggested, why don't you look at this?
Right.
At that time, there were only three bars facilitators in Mumbai and probably in India also.
Right.
There were probably one or two more in the Bangalore, Chennai, but there were three in Mumbai. So I spoke to one of them, ate her, you know, picked her brains for an hour, called again the next day and picked her brains again for an hour, and then went to the class. And well, that is now history.
Yes.
But what actually changed was, I went to Australia and Dane was facilitating a money in Melbourne.
Mm-hmm.
And money started showing up from the day I actually signed up for the class. I did not know India is on 65%. So when I went to pay for the class, they gave me back $105. It was $300 and they gave me back $105.
Wow. Yeah.
Now I had a very great point of view, $300 for one day class. But I would say my wife nudged me, why don't you go? So I went. So the money started coming in from that day. $105 before I even registered for the class.
Awesome.
Then after the class, 2 days later, there was a large amount of money due from a friend's company who has been telling me for 2 years, I will pay. But that money came without much doing anything while I was in Melbourne. It got credited to my account.
Wow.
So I thought there is something that did change in that class of one day. And well, came back to India, did 5 days of changing myself along with my wife. And well, there's no looking back after that.
Wow, how awesome is that? So when you say you had issues, would you like to speak a little bit more about what did that, did they change for you? Were they physical, were they monetary, were they relationships? Well, or was it like everything all together, rolled into one?
Well, there were, you see, as we know, all the access tools have to work all together, you know, all the 10 commandments, all the other tools, they all work together. So I think my issues are also kind of jumbled up. And it was not that this changed and that changed or that got fixed. I would say I became a better being, a better human being.
Wow.
From my wife's point of view.
That is so beautiful. Wow. You know, I just love what you just said. That's so beautiful. And it's like when your wife says you become a better human being, oh, wow. That's probably one of the best compliments a man can ever get.
Then,
yeah.
Yeah, then if your wife has said, then you have definitely become one.
Well, honestly, after coming to Access, I have stopped looking for validation from anybody, including my wife.
Yes, so true. So true. And so now you are in Mumbai and you have been facilitating for a few years now the foundation and talk to the entities. I know you're a brilliant talk to the entities facilitator also.
Yes. Yeah.
And we did have some wonderful, wonderful time together in Paris when we were there.
Yes.
For the facilitators.
Yeah, absolutely. And, that was awesome.
Yes. And so let's talk about like, you know, when we in Access, we use the term awareness quite a bit, right? It's like awareness and awareness and awareness. And when people come in, they start to use the term initially, they use the term all as very often just as a new word to play with without really knowing what truly is awareness. Well, and so often they start to, often they also start to, they start to judge by saying it's an awareness. They start to throw solidity into their own universe about their points of views, saying it's awareness. So what light can you throw on that? Where, you know, awareness is awareness.
You see, awareness is space. Anything that gives you space will also give you some awareness. And where awareness, you know, only when you acknowledge that this is an awareness, you can choose something. So, and without choice, if you have a judgment about anything, then there's no choice.
Right.
So it's only with the awareness. And awareness actually gives you the freedom to choose. And again, let me go back a little. Every one of us is aware of energies. If somebody is angry at us, we know somebody is angry. If somebody is loving us, somebody is caring for us, we know what's going on. So we all know what awareness is, but yet we don't acknowledge it so many times. And until and unless you acknowledge your awareness, whatever is showing up in your life, you will not be able to improve, change, or whatever else you may want to do with that awareness. We have actually misapplied and misidentified feelings as awareness, because feelings is for the body. Emotions are for the body. As a being, we have awareness, which then tells us or gives us choices. You know, in order to create your life, what are the four elements? All of us, I hope everybody is from Access.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So we all know the four elements of creating your life. Question. When you ask a question, it gives you an awareness. Choice. With that awareness, you choose. And then when you choose, so many other possibilities show up, which contributes to your life. Now, if we solidify all this awareness into feelings and emotions, then how do you create your life? You have already judged it to be what it is, and therefore you are not being present in your life. In order to create your life, you have to be present every moment, 24/7. There is no stopping being present in your life. And if you are present in your life, you will have awareness of anything and everything. As an infinite being, you have awareness of everything. Are you willing to acknowledge that? Are you willing to have it? Or are you are blocking it based on judgments, your point of views? Because these point of views prevents you from the awareness that will give you actually freedom. Then you don't require anything else. If you have awareness of everything, then there is oneness. Do you need anything else in life? No. But one thing that we do very dynamically is refuse to acknowledge. Or we misapply and misidentify based on this reality as to what it is and define it as something. When there is a judgment, there is no other awareness that can come up. And therefore, you stop creating your life. So without awareness, you cannot create your life.
So beautifully explained. So beautifully explained. Thank you for that.
You cut off your awareness to create a disaster in your life, is what I would say. Everywhere where you have not acknowledged your awareness, and you cut off your awareness, you have created a disaster. You can go back and go through your life, and wherever you define something as a disaster, you have not followed your awareness, which you had, but you refused to acknowledge it, or you misapplied and misidentified it as something else.
Yeah, and we've almost been trained not to follow our awareness, but to listen to other people around us who are supposed to know more than us, right?
Well, see, that is another aspect, you know. We are aware of other people's and our both. Mm-hmm. Do we value our awareness? Awareness is a valuable product. But what we value is the awareness we have about other people and not our own. You know, I'm a great, you know, proponent of, you know, I in my classes also, I quote some of the Upanishads or Gita to to explain, because Indian people understand that very, very easily. So, you know, from our, you know, grannies, we have heard, Jaan hai to jahan hai. Now,
yeah,
unless you take care of you, can you take care of anybody else? But in this reality, especially women in India, you know, they are trained, they are entrained to look after others at the cost of their own well-being. So, how does one have a life of their own? They are actually living somebody else's life, somebody else's expectations and projections. And that is why so many women, you know, Chandana, matlab in Delhi or Bombay, we are not aware of what's going on in the villages.
Yeah.
Even today, I would say almost 85% of the women in India are suppressed, oppressed. Because even when they have an awareness, they are unable to. Well, I'm going off from the track of...
No, not at all. This is all a contribution that, and this is all something that, you know, you are sharing, which is where we cut off our awareness, and which is where we create that disaster, and where we refuse to receive the gift of our own awareness.
Yes.
Yeah. And that's the beauty of every time that we actually start to acknowledge our awareness, there's so much more that's available for us, what to choose from and to be and to create. And, you know, our life itself seems to be so different when we start to trust our awareness.
The first thing is acknowledging.
Right.
And then the second thing is trusting that, yes, this is what is.
Yes.
And the third is it mine or is it somebody else's? Because most of the time, it is somebody else's. As we know, 98% of the times, all thoughts, feelings, and emotions don't belong to us. So are we creating a life based on other people's point of views? Or are we creating our life from our own awareness? If we create our life based on other people's point of views, then we know that my husband or my wife or my children, they want this, 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 this. What do you know? You know, in all my classes, most of the women that come, I ask them one very simple question. There are 4 samosas that are brought into the house and there are 4 people. Will you have yours or not? And 90% of them say they will not have it. They will wait. If somebody else wants another, they will wait for that and then only have it. So they are living other people's lives. So awareness, trust, as I said, all the access tools go hand in hand. You cannot divorce one from the other. That is why, you know, there is the book, Divorceless Relationship. Nothing can be divorced.
True that. True. Yes. Yes.
So carry on.
So I actually I'd love everyone to hop on and ask the questions. But before you hop on, I'd love to just ask you one more thing here.
Yeah.
Is that, you know, we have the awareness, but we also have the capacity to try and push our awareness down, to constantly, you know, to reject it and to say, no, I don't want to see that. I don't want to look at that.
Yeah.
So can you speak about that space of rejection of the awareness and what that can do, that what that does to us and our reality?
Okay. So what jails are you using for the dominance of E is equal to MC square, for refusing and not acknowledging your awareness to create destruction of your life, living, and your future. Everything that is time, so God, zillion, will you please destroy and create it all?
Yes, please.
Right and wrong, good, bad, pocket, pot, all night, shorts, boys, and beyonds. Let me try and repeat. What jails are you using for the dominance of E is equal to MC square? For refusing and not acknowledging your awareness to create destruction of your life, living, and your future. Everything that is time, so God, zillion, will you please destroy and create it all?
Yes.
Right and wrong, good, bad, pocket, pod, all lines, shorts, boys, and beyonds. I think your question is summed up in this.
Yes.
Clearing.
Thank you for that. Yeah.
So if you do not acknowledge, or if you refuse your awareness, you are actually destroying your life, right? Destroying your future. Awareness is a valuable product. And the earlier you acknowledge, the more you'll be able to create your life.
Right. Wonderful.
Better late than never.
Yes.
So start as soon as you can. If you haven't already. Yes, please.
Does somebody have a question?
Yeah.
Yes. Hello, ma'am. Hello, sir.
Chanchal.
My name is
Chanchal. Yes,
Chanchal. Sir, actually, I am not able to get the idea of what is awareness. Can you give me some examples so that the definition of awareness is clear to me and all of us?
See, as I explained earlier, if somebody is angry at you, do you get to know that somebody is angry at you?
Yes.
If somebody is kind to you, do you get to know that somebody is being kind to you?
Yes.
So you know the energies.
Mm-hmm.
What is awareness? Awareness is the energy of what is going on. When you ask a question, what is this? Then you get an awareness. Okay. This is this guy trying to
Now I'm getting clear about the awareness.
She just froze. Oops. Can we all contribute to that, please? And Tilly comes on again.
Yes.
Yes, she's back. Yay!
So this is awareness. When you ask a question, you get an awareness. You get the energy of what is. And unless you are present in your life, you will not get the awareness. You have to be present to have the awareness of what's going on. Because every moment there's something going on in your life. And therefore, if you wish to create moment by moment, people who have done foundation, they know 10 seconds increment. So you can choose different. How do you choose? You choose based on whatever awareness you have. Okay, I choose this. Then possibilities show up. Out of those possibilities, you choose further. That contributes. So awareness is the element by which you create your life.
Wonderful. That definitely is a meme.
Thank you so much, sir.
I do not know how to, you know, solidify it and define it like this reality.
And that is the beauty of awareness, right? You can never solidify it.
You can.
And you can really never explain it to anybody. You just got to get it when you get it.
It's space. As I said earlier, it is just space.
And also speaking about space, it's also like, you know, when we, so often initially when I would do these classes with that, and you know, an access, whether it was the first bars class or the foundation class that I sat in, there would be so much space.
Yes.
Which was such a, so uncomfortable for me, because it was like that emptiness was just not something that I was used to. And we tried, I mean, I would try so hard to fill it up.
Yes.
And that's where we also, you know, where we are being awareness with that space that you just spoke about. And because that space is so new and it could be uncomfortable. So many of us so often try to fill it up with other people's thoughts, feelings, and emotions.
Yes.
Right? And that's when we're like, oh, I don't feel good.
You know, we know that there is a drama going on between Amitabh Bachchan and Jaya Bahadur and Rekha in the movie, and yet we cry.
Yeah.
We are buying that point of view that we are seeing. We know it is unreal, and yet we buy it.
Yeah.
So anybody else's point of views are actually unreal for you. As an infinite being, you are aware of everything. The entire space, the entire universe, you are aware of.
Mm.
Whatever you have refused, or whatever you have blocked, or whatever you have not allowed to come to you, is what is not you are aware of. So, the more you acknowledge that, yes, this is this, this is this, this is this, this is this, the more you can create. Now, if I don't acknowledge this glass, then I have blocked this energy from coming. Now, as an infinite being, is there anywhere I am not there? Is there anywhere that I don't have the awareness of? But if I block this, or even a glass window, what will happen? I'll just break my head with it if I am unaware that there is a glass here. So wherever we are unaware, and we are unaware in so many places, we only create destruction of our lives.
So I have a question.
Yes, Reshma.
So we're aware of a lot of things, right? We're aware of the government doing what they're doing. We're aware of the US government doing. We're aware of Australia's forest burning down. Now, this is all awareness. Like, even with the logical mind, that is awareness.
Yeah.
Now this is not something that is actually creating greater, right? It's destruction in a lot of ways.
Right.
Now, what is the way, like, okay, I'm again getting into my head, but what is the way to actually use this awareness to create greater?
You see, what questions have you not asked that if you asked, would give you the awareness of what this actually is? And how is this contributing to you and the universe? Is the earth desiring this destruction?
Is it? I get a no.
Can anything happen?
No.
Everything
is created.
Is created. So, somebody created. Who created? For anything and everything, there is a contribution. If you judge it, you make it negative or positive. And we also have one another habit, I would say. I'm also, again, this is also a judgment that I have, a point of view, that where most of the time, if it is negative, then it's an awareness. And if it is negative, it is not so. So you have to ask the right question, the correct question. What is this? What can I do with this? Can I change it? If not, if yes, how can I change it? If not, there's nothing you can do about it. Be in the interesting point of view. If there's nothing you can do about it, either move on, be in the interesting point of view.
Or ask another question.
Or ask another question. What question have you not asked that will be what you are looking for?
Has anyone, sorry, hi, this is Zelio.
Yes, Zelio.
Has anyone got a no yet in these four questions ever until now?
Have you?
Well, there are so many times I get a yes. Can I change it? Yes. But how can I change it? And I get a no. Because.
Oh. So what questions do we ask here? When you can change it, but you get a no.
Even if you can change it, is now the time?
Oh, wow.
It is not always that you can do anything and everything at any point of time. Is now the time? There are so many creative ideas you may have. But I can tell you of so many in my life where I did so many things in business and lost money. And today, people are minting money with those things. I was too far ahead. Therefore, I lost money. The time for that idea had not come. So the was in that situation would be, is now the time?
That is something that's so beautiful, Naresh, if I can just, you know, come in here.
Yes, you know,
about is now the time. It's almost like when we are so present with the future, with the present of, you know, is now the time, and we know it's a possibility. And we are also looking at the possibility as a future. And when we come from that space and that question of is now the time, it's almost like creating a future with the present.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Yeah.
Absolutely.
And that,
absolutely. Yeah. You know, then you are not only being present in your life, you are also asking the universe to tell you, is it the time now or do I wait more? As I said, I have lost so much money because I was too ahead of time.
Yeah.
And those ideas are, people are minting money.
Yes.
So, what question have I not asked that if I ask, will change this? That's another question that I have, which I keep asking.
Hello.
Yes, Rekha.
Thank you so much for putting that across. And especially, you know, when Reshma brought this topic up as to, you know, we are aware of the Amazon burning, the bushfires in Australia. I just did a COP with Gary recently, and Gary spoke about Amazon burning there. And, you know, even he had this point of view as to why would, you know, this happen. So, I mean, why would Earth want, you know, forests and animals to die? And that's when he said that he really asked the Amazon as to, is this really happening because it wanted the same to happen?
Yeah.
And he said he got a yes.
Yeah.
So Amazon really wanted that, you know, the forest there, everything else to burn. And he said, I had this insane point of view that why would that happen? Why would Amazon want itself to burn?
Yeah.
And that's when he said, everywhere we are refusing to acknowledge that Earth is way more conscious than we are. And where are we judging the consciousness of Earth? Because of our perverted point of views as to why would someone destroy itself? And where have we bought destruction as a wrongness?
Yeah. You know, you know, you are talking about Gary, who is very, very, I would say, conscious. Today morning, I was in an Uber. And the taxi driver said, Saab, Delhi shahar mein itna gand ho gaya hai na. Hindustan, China, Thailand, ye jo area hai na, Bangladesh, ye Pakistan wagera, in sab ka to 90% log mar jayega, tabhi yahan par theek hoga.
Wow.
So,
no point of view there.
Why no point of view? But he and his family and everybody is there. Is that guy aware of something?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And thank you so much. The way you really put that up, the entire conversation, that really opened up a lot for me when the minute you said, is that the time?
Because, we have actually defined a destruction as wrong. But only when something ends can a new beginning be there. As an infinite being, spiritual. But in this reality, something has to end to create a new beginning. And who has to create that? The infinite beings who are always there. It's the infinite being who all of this. Who else? Are you willing to acknowledge?
Wow. What a beautiful, beautiful conversation. This is just fabulous. I'm loving every minute of it. And it's like, I don't know.
Some people may be feeling this guy has some perverted point of views.
No, I remember reading a book. Now I don't remember which one it was by Gary, and which he said that after destruction, when you look around, has it ever created greater or has it ever created less?
Yes.
It's always created greater. And it's just our point of view about the destruction that now everything will be destroyed. But actually, if you let it be, that's the earth's way of actually cleaning it up. And it has no point of view of the fires. It has no point of view about a volcano. It has no point of view about the earthquake. That's just the way it's pooping. It's like clearing.
It's like clearing.
Yeah.
And you see, in this reality also, we have made death wrong.
Yeah.
If you die, then a new body can be formed. You can choose something new, something different.
Mm. Yeah.
What have you made so vital, valuable, and real about your past that keeps you from creating your future? Everything that is, will you please just try and create it all?
Yes, please.
Right and wrong, good, bad, father, pod, all nine, shorts, boys, and beyonds.
Wonderful. Do we have any more questions? Ethan?
I have a question.
Yes, darling.
So is awareness knowing and perceiving? I mean, how I sometimes get the sync between these three. So am I perceiving here, or is this awareness or is this knowing?
What is perception? Perception is kind of an acoustical awareness. In perception, I think I read somewhere in the reference material So it is actually an acoustical awareness, and we try to just actually solidify it by defining it. And awareness is that space where you perceive something, and from your knowing as an infinite being, you know, oh, it is this. And then you acknowledge it. Oh, yes, it is this. So I would say awareness has sub parts to it. You put something.
I'm getting that energy.
You get that energy.
Yes.
Then when you acknowledge it, you know, then you have that, you know, that spatial feeling that, wow, this, okay, what can I do with this? And then you move forward. But if you solidify it, then that's the end of it. Then that becomes a feeling or an emotion, and you have judged it and solidified it. But as a being, you just perceive and get the awareness of what, because awareness is actually perception and knowing. As an infinite being, you perceive, know, and be, and receive everything, you know, all the energies. So it is actually the combination of knowing and perceiving that is the awareness.
Beautiful. In fact, it's like sometimes when you get an awareness, it's like so quick and so fast, and if you're not present enough, it's gone. It's like gone. And then we keep looking for it. Where did it go? And that's when we try to look for it. And then we try to pull it back and make it like a judgment. Like, oh, that's what the awareness I had, and that's the right awareness, or that was a wrong awareness. And and then so often that right awareness, which is judgment, and that wrong awareness, which is judgment. I'd love you to speak a little bit about that too, where, you know, we label it as awareness, but it's actually a judgment.
You know, I would say, Chandana, that is a fashionable to speak that way. I have the awareness, Chandana, that if you come to my foundation, it will contribute to you. So, you know. So you kind of try to make the other person agree or align with your point of view by labeling a judgment as an awareness, and then, you know, ask that person to kind of honor you. Awareness.
Yeah.
No. And no.
Dane says, cute but not smart.
It's cute but not smart. But each one has to ask the question himself or herself. What is it that contribute to them? What will contribute to me may not contribute to you, and vice versa. So we have to ask that question ourselves. And who has to create your life? You, not me. We can contribute. All of us can contribute to someone, but that person has to create his or her own life. If the person is refusing the contribution, will be created whatever it is. And if they the contribution, the life will be created whatever it is. So awareness is just knowing what is. okay, this does not work for me. Let me choose something different. Okay, this works for me, fine. So as I said, all the access tools are, you know, kind of as a cloud, which you got to keep on, you know, getting the sunlight from wherever.
Do we have any more questions?
Yes. Yeah, I have a question.
Yes.
So everything is a contribution. Is that a judge, like a conclusion, or I'm just wondering?
Everything is a contribution. People may judge it as a positive or a negative contribution. But everything is
in the same way.
But everything is a contribution.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yes. Any more questions from anybody around awareness, around judgment, or around anything else? Make the most
anything
of it.
Else. Yes.
We have Naresh Dayal on.
Okay, I'd like to ask something. I'm Usha here from Chennai. And
yes.
See, we have been brought up in a traditional way where we say mantras, slokas, and all these things, and you say so many times, and it's supposed to help and things like that. And now when you come into access consciousness, awareness is there. And so when we do with awareness, I find that I'm able to experience the energy of the vibrations of the whatever I am saying, reciting. But at the same time, I wonder, do I have to recite for my awareness to grow more, or without even the reciting, am I using like, is it like an trying to use my awareness like a backdoor? Okay, I don't want to say my mantras or slokas, so anyway, I have awareness, so why should I say? This kind of thoughts comes to me. So it's a little bit of, I'm wondering. So,
do you have a specific question, Usha, or just a general, so I can talk also a little general?
Yeah, like whether without our traditional way of reciting of our mantras and slokas, will we still have the awareness when we do this access consciousness using the tools, or what? Like,
you see, the first sentence of the manual says, consciousness includes everything and judges nothing. Consciousness includes everything and judges nothing. That is the first sentence in the BARS manual, which is the base of, I would say, access. Now, we also know all thoughts, feelings, and emotions have. So what you speak, what mantras you recite will have effect. Whether that effect will be available to you in this life, next lifetime, or 100 lifetimes later, or the next moment, nobody knows. Okay? What you have to ask is, by whatever you are doing, you see, you are getting into the doing more than the being. Okay? So, for whatever you are doing, is this, again, what is this? What can I do with this? Can I change it? If yes, how can I change it? Is this contributing to me? If it is, how is it contributing? Are you doing it just to be in the form structure and you have therefore made it significant? Or is it something that is actually contributing? As I said, the first sentence is, consciousness includes everything, judges nothing. So if this reciting of shlokas is working for you, go ahead. Absolutely. But if you have made it significant, you have solidified it, if I don't do this, this will happen. If I don't do this, that will happen. Then you are, your point of view creates your reality. Then you are actually getting into the form, structure, and significance of things, which will, whatever it will create in your life. The elements of creating your life are question, awareness, choice,
possibilities, and choice.
So with question, you get an awareness. With those awareness, you choose. With choice, you create possibilities. And with those possibilities, contribute to you. So ask these questions. You would know whether this is working for you or not. Some people say, भाई हमको तो संडे को हवन करना है, करवाना है, हर संडे को करना. Okay, if that works for you, you feel good about it, go ahead, do it. Who is stopping you? But if you have made it into a significant care, संडे को हवन नहीं हुआ, तो तुम ये रहा, ये होगा, वो होगा, then that is what is going to show up in your life. So that your point of view creates your reality. That is not working from awareness. Anything that you wish to do, ask a question. Is this contributing? Is this something that creating greater for me? If it does, go ahead. There is no judgment about it. But if you look at Hinduism, again, I'm digressing from this. They don't talk about any form and structure. It's only the, you know, karmakand, if I can use that terminology, which actually binds everything. Otherwise, it is just a way of life. And throughout Gita, it talks about the same thing. Be present in your life. Present is what will create your life. पार्थ वो तेरा दुश्मन है, भाई नहीं है, शत्रु है, तू नहीं मारेगा, वो तुझे मार देंगे. That being present, looking at what is, rather than being in the past, rather than being in the form and structure, how can I kill my brother? You know, and again in Gita talks about, you know, Virat Roop. Now, what is Virat Roop? He's saying you can be all energies. Parth, tu mujhme, main tujhme hun. What is the explanation? The explanation is this: you are an infinite being. And as infinite beings, all of us are one. If all of us are one, where is the separation?
That's how it started, right? With the consciousness of bringing everyone together and getting everyone to see the greatness in themselves. And then somewhere that was used to make money, and somewhere that was used to create control over others.
Yeah.
It actually took them away from the consciousness of what actually was. And
Went away from consciousness to form structure for control.
Yeah. Right.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes, please.
These quotes, there are these quotes like live your each day as the last day and all that. What's your awareness on that?
Sorry, I didn't get the question.
So, obviously there are a lot of quotes going, like you can see it on Instagram or internet and everywhere it's circulating. Like live your each day as the last day and all that. So what's your awareness on that? Should we really function from that space?
Have you done foundation?
Yes, I have.
The last page of the foundation manual talks about oneness.
Yes.
What does it say? Do you remember?
No.
You are living moment by moment without any projection, without any expectation. You don't know what the next moment would be.
Mm-hmm.
And there is no, comfort of the past. Hello?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. No. The noise stopped, yeah. So I thought.
Yeah. Sorry. I'm there, sir. I just muted myself.
Okay. So you see, when you have no past and you can create your future moment by moment, what is it you are doing?
Living into
time. Are you not living as if that was your last moment?
Yes.
So all these quotes have some meaning.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes.
Access has explained all this, I would say, in a very simple manner.
Amazing, yes.
For people to understand. And they have given you tools so that you can use the tools to actually make your life easy.
Yes.
But we are used to making it difficult. We are used to having struggle. We are used to making it solid. And therefore, we keep on going back to this reality, which talks about struggle being greater than anything. But something as crazy as there is a program on in Mumbai on this 98. Times of India wala kya, what is it called, that FM channel?
98.7 or 5,
yeah,
I guess
98.2.
Oh, maybe not.
Huh?
98.3, I think.
Yeah, 98.3. Yeah. What is that called? It's the Times of India channel.
Radio Mirchi.
Radio Mirchi. Yes. Radio Mirchi has a program which talks about Mumbai ka sabse bada struggler. Well, we have given actually struggle is actually glorified.
Yeah.
And whenever there is ease, we feel that there's something wrong here. How can it be so easy? Actually, life is easy. Are you choosing ease? Is the question. That is what awareness will give you. Ease.
Wow, that is something so beautiful to actually look at, because if awareness gives us ease, everywhere that there is no ease is where we are not being the energy of awareness.
We are shutting off awareness.
Yeah.
Can I ask one more question?
Yes, please.
Can you talk about chakras? How do they play a role?
Beg your pardon?
Chakras.
What about chakras?
How do they play a role? Or what?
Well, the little I know about it is they are energy meridians. What they relate to, how they relate to, what they are, honestly, I don't think I am the right person to be talking about it.
Okay. Thank you.
Awesome. Should we now go on to our next segment? Somebody has a question. Who's that?
There is somebody.
I have a question. I'm suffering from severe loneliness. I feel, and I would like to know what clearing statements to use.
Can an infinite being ever be alone? Hima, are you on the line? Are you here right now?
Yes, she is.
If she is, can she ask? What?
She probably typed it out because she wasn't able to come on. So.
I think Naresh Uncle's frozen again.
Oh. So Hema says, I am unable to use the audio at the moment.
Okay.
Well, till Naresh ji comes on, Hema, I know what he was asking you was, would an infinite being ever be alone? And whose sadness and whose loneliness are you really aware of? Is that even yours? And Naresh ji is back.
Yes. Sorry, I got disconnected. I don't know. Something wrong with the internet.
Yes, with internet. That's fine. So, Hema's question is, I have a question. I'm suffering from severe loneliness. I feel and I would like to know what clearing statements to use. She also says that she's unable to use the audio at the moment.
Okay. So, my question to her is, can an infinite being ever be alone? And does an infinite being need anybody else? Does an infinite being require? So what have you made so vital, valuable, and real about loneliness?
And probably about never being lonely also, right? Probably the rejection of that energy.
What has happened? Okay. Yes. I think she's typing something there. Oh, the complete chat has gone. When I got cut off.
Okay.
Uncle, cool. She had told us that she's not going.
Yes.
Been being able to come online. Her okay. At the moment. Yeah.
Okay. So what is she asking for? Chandana, are you clear? What is she wanting?
I think she just wants something, some awareness around the loneliness, and she'd like a clearing around that.
Well.
So the questions that you suggested are wonderful.
What is this? And I would say, go back to the four elementary questions. What is this? Is this loneliness yours or does it belong to someone else? Truth. What is this? What can I do with this? Can I change it? If yes, how can I change it? Then to you would be, talk to the entity's facilitator. They may be able to help.
All right. Now, should we go to our next segment? The fun segment.
Okay.
Where I call the guests and then I have fun with you.
Okay. All right.
All right. So
you can't have all the fun. I will also have.
All right, done. Let's have fun together.
Okay.
So I'm going to ask you a question and please share what that is for you. All right.
Okay.
So the first one, what is religion for you?
Control.
Conflict.
Conflict.
Yes, conflict.
Difference of opinion.
Awesome. What does success mean to you?
Creating your life the way you want it.
Awesome. And what is your favorite to-go-to tool, access tool? The day you want to change, the day you're having like a kind of a grumpy day. If you have grumpy days, that is.
What is this? What can I do with this? Can I change it?
I love it. What is this?
What question I haven't asked that I should be asking today?
Wonderful. Awesome. And what is the gift and the potency that you have recently discovered about yourself?
You're asking a very, very potent question.
And I hope everyone starts to wonder about that, about themselves too, with that question.
There are so many awarenesses I get every day, Chandana. I don't know.
Yes.
And
so if you could just acknowledge one capacity that you have recently tapped into that you know you have.
Well, I am more into interesting point of view than I used to be.
Beautiful.
And I think that one tool itself is helping me a great deal in my life.
Awesome. Beautiful. Thank you for that. Yes, interesting point of view is indeed one of the most beautiful tools. And I know I'm on Reshma's interesting point of view group. And that group is changing stuff in the world.
Wow. Reshma, yeah. You didn't invite me.
But I would certainly add you to the group.
All right.
And so what is possible for the future of for the unknown world that you are aware of?
What is possible for the future?
Yes.
Of the unknown world
that you are aware of.
Well, I'm aware of. How did she come on the line?
You have your beautiful wife on.
Yes, I'm here.
Awesome.
I've been here without the video.
Oh, now we see you, so we know you're on.
Yeah.
Wonderful to see you. Thank you.
One thing which I became aware of, I would say just day before yesterday. You know, marriage is something that is being talked about a lot all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
And more so in India these days, as to whether it is a good practice or a bad practice, or whether it is one should go in for it or not go in for it, and things like that. My awareness is, as an infinite being, that is the first step of becoming an infinite being, because that is communion. To me, marriage is communion.
Right.
And when you have communion with each and every molecule of the universe, then you have oneness. This marriage is the first step of actually towards becoming an infinite being.
Beautiful. Wonderful. Now we'll go to the next segment. I'm going to ask you, I'm going to say one word.
Yeah.
And please, just one word aloud from you.
Okay.
So whatever that brings up for you, okay? Choice.
Contribution.
Wonderful. Women.
What did you say?
Women.
Beautiful.
Potency.
Women.
Oh. Love.
Beautiful.
Sex.
Fun.
Awareness.
Creation.
Capacity.
Creation.
Fear.
Distractor.
Hate.
Shouldn't be there.
Victim.
Victimizer.
Marriage.
Communion.
Destruction.
New beginning.
Elementals.
We all are.
And you get 100 and 100. That was wonderful.
Oh, I'm so grateful to the teacher to have given me 100 out of 100.
Can I add something?
Please, go ahead.
This looks like a coffee with Karan, like coffee with Chandana aunty of consciousness.
Please call me Chandana. I'm so happy with just Chandana.
Auntie, it will take time for me to call you Chandana.
I know, sweetheart. I love you. You call me auntie. Call me anything. Yeah, I know lots of people in the first season of Conversations of Possibilities, and lots of people texted me actually asking me about season one. So I would like you all to know that season one is on my YouTube channel with all the different guests that we had last year. And Reshma, if you can put my link, darling, please. So
today's replay, I'll probably send you a link to her channel and you can just stream.
Awesome. Yeah. And you can go through all the conversations. We've had 8 different CFs on last time. So for everybody who was asking, there are some wonderful conversations on that YouTube channel also. And you can go check it out and, well, just have fun with it.
Is the yesterday's one already there?
Yes. Reshma is very prompt.
Okay. Great. How does it get any better than that?
She's wonderful. And she'll put it out. Will you put it out tonight, Resh?
Yes. I'll actually put out all the first 3 episodes together and probably you can have them on. You can watch them. Okay. And guys, if you'd like the updates of whichever video goes up, please hit subscribe to the YouTube link. It becomes easier for you to get an update on which video has gone up. So you don't have to ask for links anymore and reach out to people. You can just go onto YouTube and get them.
Okay.
Oh, wow. That works? I didn't know that.
It does.
You have somebody so tech savvy on. Awesome. All right. Thank you, Naresh ji. Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you, Chandana. Thank you very much.
Can I say something?
Yes, please.
You asked about his potency and he didn't mention about his potency with all the entities and the entity world. It's just awesome.
Yes.
It's like he's meant and born for this work.
Yes. I wonder where he is refusing to acknowledge that.
He knows it very well.
But it's a wrongness to talk about your potency in this world, auntie. What are you talking? Not allowed.
Not allowed.
You're not allowed to claim and acknowledge it in public. You have to be, what is that called? You have to be humble.
Yes. And let others never know it.
Yes.
So all of you on the call now know his potency.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you for sharing that.
Yes, thank you. And before we end, could I just say something, Naresh uncle? Thank you so much for talking about marriage so beautifully, because like everybody knows, that's something I have been resisting for a very long time, and finally I've dropped my walls and receiving from it. Now that I'm married, but even the possibility of getting married or even seeing somebody, and how beautifully you explained it to be a communion and an invitation of being an infinite being in it and not separating from it. So thank you for really creating that space.
Thank you for receiving it. Thank you very much.
Would you like to share about your upcoming classes so everyone knows where to reach you? I know you are on Facebook. And where else can
they
find you?
I'm on Facebook. I'm not on Facebook because...
Oh. I just assume everybody's on Facebook.
No. I'm there, but I hardly visit Facebook. I have my classes in Delhi starting Sunday.
And Sunday, that's the foundation?
Sunday is the bars and Funny. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday is the foundation. And then I have classes in Mumbai. 24th is the intro for Talk to the Entities. And 25th, 26th is Talk to the Entities beginning. And most probably 31st or so, I would be, or first week of February, I'll be having foundation again in Mumbai.
Awesome. So everybody on the call who wants to reach out and get more of this yummy energy, you know where to find him.
Yeah, and in February there is a foundation in Hyderabad also. The dates are not yet finalized, but there would be one.
Awesome. That is so wonderful to know. And thank you all. Thank you
very much, Chandana.
Oh, thank
for inviting
you.
Me and for this wonderful
my
conversation.
Pleasure, totally my pleasure. And I know it's been
I thoroughly enjoyed it and thank grateful to you and everybody.
Thank you. And we'll see you all tomorrow, same time, same place for our fourth CF.
Yes.
Watch out.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Chandana. I see you all
in every call and it's such a gift. Thank you. Sweet.
It's because you're such a big contribution. I mean, I enjoy, you know, what you've created for everybody.
Thank you. It's
such a delight to hear each and every person who comes on to the call. And it just opens up so much during each call. So a big thank you to you for creating it. And a big, big thank you for all the guests who come on and open up so much for all of us. So thank you
for receiving it.
Melting my world.
Thank you so much, Naresh. Thank you,
darling.
Thank you. It's a pleasure meeting everybody in this Zoom call.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Yeah.
Have a great night ahead. Go have some fun.
Yeah.
See you tomorrow. Yeah. Bye.
Yes. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye.